What is going on, everyone? My name is Ken, also known as Wiltshire, and today I'm going to show you guys the easiest and best method to connect your PlayStation 3 controller to your Windows PC without having to use Motioninjoy or Better DS3. Before I start the tutorial, I just want to say that you are going to need a PlayStation 3 controller with a mini USB cable, as well as a Bluetooth dongle. However, this is completely optional. That is only if you want to use your controller wirelessly. Now what we're going to do is we're going to take your PlayStation 3 controller and or your Bluetooth dongle and plug them into your computer. Now what this will do is this will install the default drivers for our PlayStation 3 controller and or our Bluetooth dongle. Now this is a very, very crucial step, so please do not forget to do this. Now there are a few more requirements that we have to take care of before we continue on with anything else. Now we have to install Microsoft.NET Framework 4.0 on our computer. If you're running Windows 8, this will come pre-installed on your Windows 8 installation, so you don't have to worry about that. If you're running Windows 7, Vista, or XP, you will have to install this or check if it's installed in case Windows Update has already done this for you. Now, we also have to make sure that we have Visual C 2010 runtime installed on our computer, as well as the latest DirectX runtime and the latest Xbox 360 controller drivers available from Microsoft. Now, you can find all of these installation requirements in a packaged zip folder for you in the description below. Make sure you install each and every single one of these requirements before we continue on with the tutorial. So with that said, I'm going to quickly run you guys through on how to install the programs. Now, the first thing that I'm going to install is the Xbox 360 controller drivers from Microsoft. Now, this one's really straightforward. All you have to do is open it, accept the agreement, and click the next button, and this will install the Xbox 360 controller drivers for you. Now, the program will ask you to restart your computer. I would recommend waiting to install everything and then restarting your computer after you've installed the last required file. So what we're going to do is we're just going to click no on that restart message, and now what we're going to do is we're going to install the Microsoft.NET Framework 4.0 file, and since I'm running Windows 8, it will say that this is already a part of the operating system and you cannot install it, as you can see right here on the first line. So if you have Windows 7, Vista, or XP, it may say otherwise, and all you have to do is click the continue button and the setup will do its thing. It'll install Microsoft .NET Framework 4.0 for you. So the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to update our DirectX runtime. Now, if you have a lot of Steam games, chances are Steam has upgraded this for you when you've gone to launch a game. So what we're going to do is we're just going to open it up really quickly, accept the agreement, click next, and we're definitely not going to install the Bing bar because Bing definitely sucks, and I'm a Google fan through and through. So this will take a long time to install. Or if you're like me and you have a newer version or equivalent version that has been updated, you'll be perfectly fine. All you have to do is click finish. If you haven't had a version of DirectX on here, it may take about 10 minutes to install. So the next thing that we're going to install is we're going to install the Visual C 2010 runtime. And this one is also pretty straightforward. If you also have a version that is already installed like myself, you will not have to install this, but if you don't, again, click the continue button and you will be good to go. So that is all the required files. Now we can continue on with the tutorial. Okay, so the very last step that we have to do is now we have to install the installation files for the PlayStation 3 controller and or our Bluetooth dongle. Now you can find this package in the description below, again, with the one big package for everything that you need to install. You'll notice a slight difference in my video that I have a 7-zip file, and in the package there will be a zip folder instead, because I don't want you guys having the hassle of trying to download something to extract that archive file, such as WinRAR, WinZip, or 7-zip, or something to extract the contents of that file. So I'm just going to open this up and extract the files. Again, it'll look somewhat different when you open up a zip folder, but it's basically the same concept. In this file, we have a folder called SCP Server, and this is what we're after, so we're going to drag and drop that onto our desktop or anywhere where you can basically find that file folder. Feel free to put that wherever you like. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to open up the SCP Server file folder, and you'll notice that there's now two file folders. Now, you don't have to pay any attention to the source file folder. On second thought, you know what, just go ahead and delete that source file folder, because this is for program developers, and if you don't know how to code or anything, or don't know how to contribute to this program, then you really don't have to worry about that. So what we're after is the bin folder. Now, this is where the installation files are. So before we do anything else, we need to go to our start menu, go to computer, go to our local C drive, go to Program Files, and what we need to do is we need to create a folder called Scarlet Crush space Productions. Now, this is very, very key because you want to keep things nice and organized on your computer, and you don't want to have this file folder just laying around anywhere. So, once you've created a new file folder, and you can do so by hitting Control-Shift-N on your keyboard, that's just a shortcut for creating a file folder, or you can right-click and go to New and then create another file folder that way. So, what we're going to do is we're going to open this up, and as you notice, I already have a bin file folder in this file folder. So what you want to do is you want to go to the SCP server file folder that we've extracted from the archive file. And what you want to do is you want to drag and drop that into your Scarlet.crush productions file folder that is in your program file folder. Now I'm not going to do that because I've already done so, I'm just going to start the program up now. To make life easier, what you want to do is you probably want to make a shortcut on your desktop for the SCP driver and the SCP monitor. Because you don't want to keep going back in your program's file folder and finding this file folder and then running things when you've found it finally. What you want to do is you want to right-click on the two and go to Send To and then click Desktop and it'll create a shortcut for you. I have mine nicely organized in my fences here. So as you can see, I already have a shortcut for the SCP driver and the SCP monitor. The monitor is basically just to show you that your controllers are connected. So what we're going to do is we're going to run the SCP driver and make sure you run this as administrator. You do need to have administrative privileges to install this. Now, make sure that your controller and your Bluetooth dongle are still plugged in. And what you want to do is you want to click the install button if you're on Windows 7 or Windows 8. Now, if you're an XP or Vista user, you have to check off Force Installer. This won't work. So, since I'm on Windows 8, I'm going to uncheck that. And I'm just going to click the install button, and it's going to install everything that I need for my Bluetooth dongle and my PlayStation 3 controller. You no longer have to deal with Motioninjoy and loading the drivers yourself and all that garbage, or loading the drivers manually through Device Manager like I showed you in the last video. Now, if everything went smoothly, you'll notice that underneath the install summary, it'll say SCP DS3 service, bus device, DS3 USB driver, and Bluetooth driver. Now, if your Bluetooth dongle is not supported, you won't see Bluetooth driver at all. I do recommend getting the ASUS BT2011 Bluetooth dongle because that is the one that is basically the most compatible with Motioninjoy and whatnot. So now that that's done, we now have our PlayStation 3 controller acting as an Xbox 360 controller on our PC. Now, this has the most compatibility with games because most games use X input, and obviously it's a Microsoft product, so obviously we can't use a PlayStation 3 controller on Microsoft Windows. So if you open up the monitor tab, it'll say that the server is now connected, and what you can do is you can unplug your PlayStation 3 controller and it should connect like a normal controller. Now, I have mine on Bluetooth, so mine's going to automatically connect itself to Bluetooth. And if you open up the DS3 monitor, you'll now see that I have a controller connected under pad 1. And this will show you your battery life as well. And so notice how it says high on the right-hand side. My battery life is probably between 80% to 100%. And if it says full, you obviously have full battery. If it says medium, you're probably at a 50% range. If it says low, you're probably at 25%. So there's a few things that you should also know about the DS3 tool is that if you load the Bluetooth driver for the DS3 tool or SCP DS3, it will override everything else. Now, that Bluetooth dongle can only connect your PlayStation 3 controllers. It cannot connect a Bluetooth mouse, headset, or keyboard. Just keep that in mind. So you do need to have another dongle if you want to use your other Bluetooth devices. So a trick for the PS3 controller, if you're done with it and you no longer want to have it on, if you're using Bluetooth, what you can do is you can hold L1, R1, and the PS button, and it will disconnect our PlayStation 3 controller for us like so. Now, you'll notice how it says reserve. Now, every time you connect that controller, that specific controller, that is the MAC address where you see the 0016 and so on, that is the MAC address. So every time we connect this controller will always be pad number 1. So you may want to label your controllers, or if you honestly get mixed up in connecting your controllers and you somehow end up with, I don't know, controller number 2 instead of controller number 1, you can always go back to the SCP driver, uninstall it and reinstall it, and you'll be good to go for your controller. So I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. this is probably the most easiest method I can ever think of for connecting your PlayStation 3 controller to the PC and playing games with it. So again, I hope you guys enjoy the tutorial. If you guys have any questions, don't forget to leave them in the comment section below. I'll be happy to answer them for you. If you guys like this video, don't forget to hit the like button below. If you guys really like this video, don't forget to hit the subscribe button for more content like this. My name's Ken, also known as Wiltshire, and I will see you guys in the next video. And don't forget, if it's easy to follow, it's easy to learn. We'll be right back.